Hip resurfacing, Wikipedia audio. Hip resurfacing has been developed as a surgical alternative to total hip replacement. The procedure consists of placing a cobalt chrome metal cap, which is hollow and shaped like a mushroom, over the head of the femur while a matching metal cup is placed in the acetabulum, replacing the articulating surfaces of the patient's hip joint and removing very little bone compared to a THR. When the patient moves the hip, the movement of the joint induces synovial fluid to flow between the hard metal bearing surfaces, lubricating them when the components are placed in the correct position. The surgeon's level of experience with hip resurfacing is most important, therefore, the selection of the right surgeon is crucial for a successful outcome. Health-related quality of life measures are markedly improved and patient satisfaction is favorable after hip resurfacing arthroplasty. The potential advantages of hip resurfacing compared to THR include less bone removal, a reduced chance of hip dislocation due to a relatively larger femoral head size, an easier revision surgery for any subsequent revision to a THR device because a surgeon will have more original bone stock available. The potential disadvantages of hip resurfacing are femoral neck fractures, aseptic loosening, and metal wear. Due to the retention of the patient's complete femoral neck, other advantages exist. Surgeon-induced discrepancies in leg length are now minimized. Also, the toe-in or toe-out faults that could occur interoperatively with THR are now over because the femoral neck that determines foot direction is left undisturbed with hip resurfacing. On February 10, 2011, the U.S. FDA issued a patient advisory on metal-metal hip implants, stating it was continuing to gather and review all available information about metal-on-metal hip systems. On June 27, 28, 2012, an advisory panel met to decide whether to impose new standards. No new standards, such as routine checking of blood metal ion levels, were set, but guidance was updated. Advantages and disadvantages. Patient suitability for hip resurfacing is decided by the patient's anatomy and the patient's surgeon. Hip resurfacing is intended for younger patients who are not morbidly obese, are clinically qualified for a hip replacement, have been diagnosed with non-inflammatory degenerative joint disease, do not have an infection, and are not allergic to the metals used in the implant. Hip resurfacing should not be used on patients who have severe bone loss in their femoral head, those with large femoral neck cysts present or cysts that are close to the head-neck junction, or patients who have poor bone stock or osteoporosis. Caution should be used for patients who have rheumatoid arthritis, are tall, thin, or small-boned, those with osteonecrosis to the femoral head, or those with femoral head cysts 1 cm on an X-ray taken before surgery. Metal-on-metal resurfacing systems are generally unsuitable for women of childbearing age due to unknown effects of metal ion release on the fetus. Patients with any of these conditions may not be suitable candidates for hip resurfacing. There are hip resurfacing components that have a ceramic coating on metal femoral head component and cross-linked polyethylene plastic as a liner for the socket or cup area, making it not metal-on-metal. The plastic sleeve can be replaced if needed without removing the main components. Not all surgeons use these, but by far the best from causing metalosis. A surgeon who does use this method is. In 2006, the United States FDA approved hip resurfacing using the Birmingham Hip Resurfacing System, designed by British orthopedic surgeon Derek McMinn. All other FDA-approved devices have been removed from the U.S. market. The BHR is no longer suggested for use in women. However, it would be the best choice for young men with osteoarthritis, According to the Australian National Joint Replacement Registry, reports that for men under 55 years of age with osteoarthritis, the Birmingham hip resurfacing is the best performing of all kinds of hip replacements in Australia. There are several other manufacturers of hip resurfacing systems, mainly in Europe. Another THR and hip resurfacing system, the DPI-ASR, which had been undergoing clinical trials for hip resurfacing in the United States and marketed overseas, has been recalled as a result of having been proven to have abnormally high revision rates. A prospective patient, therefore, needs to be cautious to confirm the type of device being used has an acceptable track record. Subtle differences among the devices in terms of design, manufacturing, and surgical technique can prove to be detrimental to clinical success. Kay Glenn won the high jump at the National Senior Olympics. http://issuu.com/orlandolife/docs/gbnovdis13/27 E=649949/5415221, Ron Norman, who on July 24, 2010 won the Masters division of the NPC Empire States Bodybuilding Championships only 5 months after hip resurfacing surgery, Corey Folk, who finished a marathon 3 months after his surgery, and finished 11th in the Ultraman World Championship 11 months later, Ian McLaren, of the Torishin Karate Club, who is believed to be the first fifth Dan Karateka in the world to have had both hips. Resurfaced Slater Williams seventh Dan Shotokan Karate had both hips resurfaced 1999-2000, Floyd Landis, the 2006 Tour de France winner. His procedure was performed after the Tour win. Joe Tierney completed the 2011, 2012, and 2013 Sillamäe's Revenge 50-mile endurance race 18, 30, and 42 months, respectively, after resurfacing surgery on his left hip. This single-track course through the Ozark Mountains has been designated as epic by the International Mountain Bike Association. Ed Jovanovski, NHL player, defense Florida Panthers. Only 9 months after having the procedure, Ed returned to the NHL. He was the first athlete to return to a major professional team sport after having the procedure done. Chase Polson, Olympic Taekwondo champion, returned to training athletes only 6 months after the procedure. Colby Lewis, MLB pitcher. 7 months after having the procedure, Colby returned to baseball. He became the first player to return to MLB after hip resurfacing. Gene Nelson of the Florida Aikikai fifth Dan. Bilateral resurfaced hips. 2005 and 2009. The hip resurfacing devices are metal-on-metal articulating devices which differ from total hip replacement devices because they are more bone-conserving and retain the natural geometry. A THR requires that the upper portion of the femur bone be cut off to accept the stem portion of a THR device. The femur cap of the hip resurfacing devices does not require the femur bone be cut off, instead the top of the femoral head is shaped to closely fit the underside of the cap. Both hip resurfacing and hip replacement require that a cup is placed in the acetabulum of the hip socket. The main advantage of the hip resurfacing surgery is that when a revision is required, there is still an intact femur bone left for a THR stem. When a THR stem requires a revision, the metal stem in the femur has to be removed and often more bone is lost in the process of removal and replacement with a larger diameter stem. Having a hip resurfacing at a younger age means that a revision will likely be easier to perform when required. Recent studies have shown that the outcome of a hip resurfacing is dependent on surgeon experience and that proper positioning of hip resurfacing components is crucial. Therefore, in addition to ensuring that a proven device is used, patients should take care in selecting a surgeon with experience and a good track record. Although formal labeling restrictions exist in some countries, including the United States, hip resurfacing may allow younger, active people to return to many activities they enjoyed prior to their hip problems, which is an advantage over a traditional hip arthroplasty. The large size cap and cup of the hip resurfacing devices are the same size as a person's original ball and socket and thus are less prone to dislocation. An often forgotten but very important advantage of hip resurfacing and thereby the retention of the femoral neck is the fact that hip resurfacing has the least measurable amount of stress shielding when compared to any type of THR. This means that with hip resurfacing, the femur's upper portion fully retains its natural mechanical characteristics under load, also ensuring less disturbance of the processes that place inside bone that is alive. There are many athletes with resurfaced hips that continue to compete at the personal and the professional level in a myriad of activities. They include: in August 2010, DePuy Orthopedics, Inc., issued a voluntary recall of the ASR trademark XL acetabular system and ASR trademark hip resurfacing system after new information from the UK National Joint Registry indicated that the number of patients who required a second hip replacement procedure, called a revision surgery, was higher than previously reported data. Potential complications include pseudotumors, metallosis, alveol, and femoral neck fracture. Patient selection. Devices. Procedure. Notable athletes. Recall.